That's awesome.
Yeah.
Hi, Jake.
Hello.
Does that thing have night vision? Because you can see right through my blouse.
It does have night vision.
That's... Say something to the audience.
Yeah, give me like a flip the bird or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck
that's
yeah.
That's a classic.
Badass. More rock in the background.
Fuck yeah.
I'm just gonna be circle pitting back here. Yeah, so the hammock's up. It's looking good. Jake mounted the TV. That seems pretty stable, actually. He's got the bar up back here. And then there's the bed. And loft.
Where's the motorcycle going?
Yeah, that's kind of the question.
Sideways and then pile everything else up under the bed. That's probably what I'll have to do. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, it wouldn't be a road trip with you, me, and Mitch without having at least one disassembled motorcycle in the vehicle.
That's true. Historically, it's factual.
It's just traditions. And there's pretty old Colorado.
For the bed, and then like the countertop basically.
Are you a trainer there?
And then he just threw everything else together.
So
it's like pretty straightforward.
Basically, like sold memberships and all that shit.
Alright.
It had to be stripped first.
For me, like, more than anything, it was a free gym membership.
Yeah.
But they had some cash on top of it. They offered
mine,
to sponsor me to be a personal trainer.
I think he wants to beat it.
Which I should have taken. But I knew I was leaving, so I was like, I'm just not going to do that to him.
But so
well, I should have done it anyway, because I would have been
certified.
So
they were already in school.
Yeah, and they got to leave.
Right.
To be a certified person on top of all
of them. Hi, Mitch.
What up, dog?
Personal trainers
are fun. Is that like night vision?
One
yeah.
It's a triathlete.
That's sick.
And they use that.
I thought it would come in.
How are you supposed to have fun in Alaska if you can't add them?
There's no way.
We can definitely do that too.
I don't really know what I'm doing with this, so. Drive car fast, hit ball.
Yeah, I know, but
it's always a hard part.
Hitting the ball is hard.
Mitch is pretty good at it, so you're in for a treat.
Gotten better.
I'm pretty terrible at it.
So here on the eve of our departure, Jake just disassembled his bike, stashed it. That's the front wheel.
Stashed it.
Let's see here. There she is. Not the first time.
Yeah.
Probably won't be the last either.
No.
Yeah, the other day I was driving Mitch's truck and the goddamn wheel fell off. That was a cool time. But looks like it's fixed now. Let's see. You can see Horse Tooth Rock from here. Yeah, you can.
Yeah, you should be
able to. Let's give the people a zoom. And go see. I swear to God, you could see it here. See the van too. That right there is Horse Tooth Rock. Named aptly for its horse tooth shape. And it's also being a rock.
Hey guys.
Okay.
Finally getting the fuck out of town.
Fuck yeah.
Just checking out some the road. So what's like the next biggest town? Cheyenne?
Cheyenne.
Nice.
About 1 hour. Well, from here, probably like 40 minutes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
And then from Cheyenne, the next town is Casper.
Ooh, Cheyenne!
That's north, right?
Not Jasper, we're in Casper. Oil City. Over here, we are parked for a little while. These dudes are like getting ready and shit. We're hanging out here for a few hours. So we gotta go to the Humane Society. And as you can see, this shit's really just popping off around here. Very flat. We stayed last night at a parking lot. It's like a little like truck stop type place. They had a bar there that was kind of, it was shitty, but it was kind of fun. I'm just gonna go take a walk downtown, see what's up. Thank you. Paul just playing Super Smash Brothers. He was driving. Yeah, we missed it, but we just drove right through that. No problem. Got to do the casino. Montana. Beautiful, beautiful town so far.
Check it out.
Don't press my buttons. Duty free. Yeah, pay for that duty.
America.
That's the border. Right over there's free country. We're in communist Canada. Like an occupied Canada.
All right, I have half a gig of normal speed data per day.
Oh, did you buy it?
No, it's included in my plan. I upgraded it last year when I came up.
Oh, okay.
But it like basically throttled it up. So, do we say A a lot? It's like, honestly, man, from my perspective, no, the person never says it. Say A so much, it's blown my mind. I was like, I thought it was just a stereotype, but they crack it up this whole time. And they were both like super embarrassed. They were like, God damn it, every time an American.
What happened to the console? It came off mid-flight. Just kidding. But ran into some difficulties and we hit Mitch. He's stuck under the van. Jake's trying to rescue him by going in through the back. I just made myself some ramen. The most gourmet ramen I've ever made.
Salome!
Salome, hey Mitch.
You know what they say?
Okay, I'm gonna blow up on this.
Oh, go for it. Alright.
Really lucky that traveling with dudes that know how to do shit.
Hey, Dave.
Yeah.
Can you go in the tool bag and hand me, there's brushes with big plastic bristles?
Yeah. Fake bristles.
Are you gonna try and pour it out over here?
Alright, later, y'all.
Let's get the rest of that shit off here first.
I think that's it. I think, like, that's the fucking
rent.
What'd you guys do?
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Huh?
What'd you guys do?
Well, we took the old gas tank.
Pulled it right off.
Out from under the bus.
Y'all pulled it off.
Well, see, what happened was Jake accidentally put diesel in the tank, so now we got to drain it.
Oh, my goodness. Classic rookie mistake.
Classic Lovelace.
Damn it, Lovelace! Well, at least we broke down in scenic Alberta.
Just for the record, that's not what actually happened.
No.
It got this cool rotating sound with the cat puncture. So these handsome boys took the gas tank off, replaced the fuel pump,
and then
we dumped a couple gallons of gas into there so it's easier for them to lift the gas tank back up to strap that bad bitch in. So.
We
are here in Calgary, and we're under this spinning sign still. Mitch was kind enough to break down next to a dispensary over there for me, which I guess I can't even zoom into, but it's over there, promise.
Is
We got Subway over here. We use their toilets. And should be pretty good pretty soon. Because they got it all hooked up. We made some ramen. We made some coffee right there. And get these like Canadian dudes over there. They helped us push up the van.
You do, don't
super
get
nice. Super.
Which one?
The motherfucker works. Still by the rotating liquor sign. Now it looks like we just gotta pack it up, get the gas back in the tank, and hit the road, I guess, right?
Fuck yeah.
Woo! I slept through camera last night and I woke up and what? They're like these big ass nuns. Everything's written in Canadian here. I don't understand anything. It's a cool tree, or a couple of them. They have slow children here. We're still in bumfuck, but now we're in even more bumfuck. Everything's all muddy. And got some trucks and shit. Iced. That's for icing me on my birthday.
It's a plastic bottle. It's really fun.
Imprecise words.
What was that?
No way. That's so fucking
dreamy. Stand off and send me. Yeah, my chicken is told them it's a feeling. Glass off, buckshot into my ceiling. Why ain't nobody saw me, I was bleeding.
If I remember correctly, I took my whole ice in one knee.
No way, it's yeah. Too warm.
I got it from
my knee. It's too warm.
It's ice.
It's the coldest smeared off ice in Canada.
That's the finest ice there in Alberta.
Seeing some wildlife out here.
What is there, a big booty wild beast looking ass bitch pumping gas?
Yeah, pretty much. No, it's like old Drippy from Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Oh,
Thanksgiving.
Chicken in here. Seeing your spread there, bro.
Chicken, spices, potatoes. Holy moly, for God's sake.
The boy's drinking down on some mimosas.
Whatever this is. Old style pilsner, Vieri.
Vieri.
Guy Vieri.
Guy Vieri. So how you make Thanksgiving dinner, dude?
Well, what I do is I boil water. I put a fuck ton of oregano and pepper and onion and garlic with a can of chicken, typically in a bigger bowl, but this bowl was in too.
Mm-hmm.
Add the boiling water, and then add an instant foil-loaded baked potato and stir until it's thick. And then bust up some bread, like stuffing, and throw it in.
Mm-hmm.
It's very, very good.
Nice.
It's delicious. Well, sometimes do cranberry sauce with it too.
Sounds dang. We'll check in on the finished product.
Yeah.
What you making, Mitch?
Just a hodgepodge of shit.
Just baking.
It's pretty much ready.
You ready?
Pretty close.
I'm pretty close.
Is Jake ready?
Getting there. Water's almost boiled. Mitch is making mac and cheese. Two types of mac and cheese, fucking mayonnaise, fucking water.
Fucking
fucking.
So it's
fucking noodles.
Annie's mac and cheese, easy mac, and ramen.
Oh, and you toss a ramen in too. That's insane.
It is wild. That is gonna be fucking awesome. Movie.
Hell yeah.
Let's keep it going. I love that little wire across it that shows you that the flames going in sunlight since you can't see the blue flame.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
The Inferno product is fucking amazing. Truly Thanksgiving dinner. A la Love Race.
Damn it.
And it, well, Mitch is the Mac Attack.
The Mac Attack. So funny.
Springs. Found another weed, and the boys found themselves a climbing guide, and we're gonna go check out the hot springs again. This is where we're at. And this is like all the shit we had to drive through. Some big ass country and province.
Yeah, yeah, that's like the bin.
Yeah, I was just in there, yeah.
We got a birthday berry in the house. Big 3-2.
No.
Fire just got nice and stuck.
Can confirm we are stuck, but we are working on getting here. Cool place to get stuck. There's just an unreal amount of signs from around the world. So Mitch is letting us use his bondage chains to get us out.
Right. Just twice.
This, finally his kink came in handy. Oh dude, what happened to the gas cap?
No, no, like in real life, they're like,
on your phone.
On my phone. They're like huge right in front of us. So yeah. They look like little dots.
So we're in Whitehorse, Canada, Yukon Territory. I took an illegal dump and smoked a legal joint. Cleaned up the van while the dudes are doing some climbing. Just needed to kind of chill, get my alone time in. Bought all of my shit for the next couple, hopefully months, but probably more like weeks. But I got my setup. I got the 5-piece premium combo. It was our trail outdoor equipment tent. So basically I got 2 chairs, 2 shitty little sleeping bags, which I kind of need a warmer weather sleeping bag anyway. And then it's supposed to fit 6 people, I think, which is a little smaller than I wanted, but you know, with all the money not being there and all that shit, we're just gonna have to make do. We went to some random fucking neighborhood and scoped out some place the dudes wanted to climb at. Then pretty much it was just like that. And yeah, we weren't at where we thought we were, I think, and we were just like kind of in people's backyards essentially, but it was kind of fun. And yeah, so got back to the Walmart and spent the night near there. After like the night before, I totally went in at 10 o'clock when they closed, and I was like, oh shit, like I don't know if we're gonna be leaving here and I'm not gonna get enough stuff for the next couple weeks, because like food is so expensive in Haines apparently. So yeah, I was just like desperately grabbing cans of beans and shit, and they were really fucking pissed. They were like, sir, we are closed on over the intercom and shit. They were like acting like it wasn't just me though, because I thought Mitch was in there, and so I was like in solidarity running, getting shit. But no. Yeah.
I think we're good. To Haines Junction?
You think?
Why would that be?
They're dry running completely. It's, I mean, the rain is peeled off.
Oh, actually,
yeah, it'll keep moving. And it'll blow.
There's something wrong with your tire, brother.
Whatever, maybe we'll make it to me, maybe not.
Good times.
Whatever the case, we're very close.
Awesome up here. So steep.
How's she looking?
It popped.
Oh no. Back.
His back for him through her brains right out the front. I was in love. I strangled mine. Did you love her? It's okay. Maybe I am a killer. Why should you care? You just stare at me.
Like, all that shit's not
really
understood. It probably is. Just warm up dramatically.
So I'm finally in Haines, and I got my setup, just still unpacking and organizing, but I am fucking stoked. Oh, gotta watch out for that little hole. I'm up on pallets right now. Here they are.
Got Mitch on the camcorder.
For the first time. Alright, let's go cam some shit.
Shit, yeah.
Yeah. We're gonna go cam some shit.
Speaking of cam, I'm just... Yeah, Judson.
He was a good boy.
That cam Judson.
What are you drinking?
The Olympic mountain beer.
Hell yeah.
Olympia.
Well, there's mountains out here.
Olympia.
Olympia.
Santa Maria.
Where are we going?
Cinco de Mayo.
Last summer, Trevor had a tour out here, and they had stopped the bus here, and he was, like, walking him over to take him to the dock or something, and he had, like, you know, 15-20 people outside of his bus, and he got out, and there was a sow coming from out of the woods right here, and it walked directly up to, like, it was walking towards the group of people who were all standing by the bus. And Trevor's like this lanky kind of goofy dude, and he's like, okay, I need you all to stand together, back away from the bear, and I need you in the bus right now. And they pulled their phones out and started walking towards the bear. And he said, I need you to get, and we call this guide voice. That's when you go from, like, being friendly to being super serious. Mm-hmm. And he was like, get in the bus now, like, yelling at them. And they, like, finally got in, and the bear, like, came up to the fucking window and shit.
God.
And they were all just pulling their phones out, walking towards it.
That doesn't surprise me, though.
Are you gonna shotgun a beer?
No, I don't shotgun shit. That's my policy.
I won't tell anybody.
I just do. Like, if I shotgun a beer, I instantly throw up every single time. It's basically like, do you want to throw up right now? No, I don't. I really fucking hate throwing up.
Specifically what I want to do is throw up. Shotgunning the beer is
pure
not a
instigation.
Priority. I just want to vomit.
Yeah.
I'm obsessed with vomiting.
I'm gonna, yeah, the only way I can induce vomit is by shotgunning the beer.
There's only two things that induce vomiting for me. Shotgunning the beer and thinking about my dad.
For me, there's only two things. It's funny. It's shotgunning beer and thinking about your dad. Oh, look, I'm thinking about it. Look, I'm thinking about it right now.
You just open your throat and I just look back in there. There's a little bit of puke bubbling up.
Look, I'm thinking about your dad.
I can control it now, but it's coming.
Isn't that crazy? I'm thinking about your dad right now.
It's so dry. Oh my god, I just got misted. Oh my poor puppy. This is going to be a
Oh my poor puffy.
Oh my poor puffy.
Yay!
Thank Jesus. Thank Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Dude, like.
When they landed on.
Oh, hold up.
Goddamn wild, man.
I'm just seeing the smell.
Beep. Oh, beep it out.
Yeah.
I probably actually didn't even pick that up either. Because my camera's like outside.
Yeah.
Alright, don't say anything incriminating right now. Don't talk about the murders. Oh, fucking hammer.
Austin, I just got back from the marijuana store.
The weed shop.
Mr. Wana.
The awkwardest place on planet fucking Earth.
It really is. That girl in there.
Who's the Cramps?
Who's the Cramps?
The Cramps? The what Cramps. Kind of band is that? Yeah,
like, oh, it's punk rock.
Yeah.
Rap, yeah. Man.
Yeah. At least we didn't get the dude. There's a dude in there that will tell you 4 to 5 stories without breaking a fucking stride, and it's absolutely terrible.
Should I cop a few?
Gonna get stoned.
Can I eat you?
We got, oh yeah, what was the name of this boat?
The Crystal Methany.
The Crystal Methany.
Or the Anal Symphony.
The Anal Symphony.
What you prefer.
This is where we pick up all the cabbages off the boat. All the cabbages to take out so they can fucking fall on their goddamn asses. Follow, we can have to fill out incident reports. Oh, there's the dude with the fucking bird on his shoulder. I don't know if he had it, but he usually
does.
Dude,
we picked up that dude at Chilcat State Park on the side of the road.
Yeah.
And there was a mama moose like within 30 yards of him, and he was like, I just need a ride for a second.
Oh, yeah, that would be scary. Right, we gotta go to the hooch store. Get some grog. Got the 2019 fucking liquor combo. Truly and gin.
Truly though.
Truly. Truly the best. Now we're pantsing. Over here's the fucking turd hole that you dump.
Yeah,
all the goddamn groover shits into that fucking hole. All the all-you-can-eat buffet shits
those
that these people
cabbage,
take.
Buffet,
these cabbages.
Avid. Sphincter tearing.
Oh my god, just ripping
shit.
Buttholes. Just so much shit. It never stops. Every fucking day there's new turds deposited in those honey buckets.
And now Dave Smith is a creeper because he is camcording a fucking school.
Oh, god damn it.
They told you couldn't be within 500 feet of
stop. Time. Shh. Who's that? This is Merlin, one of the fleet.
So you put it on, it goes over your head. What else? No standing up while I'm underway. If we see a moose, I will stop when I find deep enough water. And if standing up gives you a better look at it or a better picture, I let you do that. If somebody tall is in front of you and they're in your way, you can karate chop them right in the back, and that will make them sit down. But really, be nice to people. Just
hear me on the PA. All right, if it gets too loud, give me a thumbs down.
He's ghosting my ass. All right. Bye.
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 Hey, Rustin.
Hey, Rustin. Dave, you're loving this. You're loving this camcorder.
Park when we get back.
Peeling out. Peeling out. Oh, there's the bridge.
All right, so I'm gonna go up on step. That means we're gonna go a little faster.
Woo!
Gull that it'll eat your shift at the beach, but here. Oh, yeah, there's a... Is that a fledgling? That eagle that's behind the logs on the right. So, we're gonna get the boat turned. This Kahini's coming in raging right now. Yeah, look, that's a fledgling, isn't it? That bird flew out of the nest within the last week, I bet. No,
oh, I got
it's not a fledgling, never mind. Not a fledgling.
I'm seeing those.
But the fledglings are starting to make their way out. What that eagle's doing is guarding that little channel, waiting for a salmon to come upstream. I'm going to go down to this last, that little spot down here on the left. There's a few more adult bald eagles in the river. So we're pointing down, that's Klukwan, the native village. I see one, two, three eagles.
How deep is the water here, do you reckon? How deep?
How deep? Right there on the right, it's fairly deep. I'm probably on about 4 foot of water. But either way I go, I can go suck rocks if I scoot it over just a little bit. So yeah, we got one, two, three, four eagles, one eagle eating. That eagle in the middle had his head down like he was eating something. We got five ravens downstream harassing an eagle. Two of them flying across, three of them flying down. Oh, he got a fish in one claw. I think the adult, the white-headed one, I think it had something in one talon. And then this juvenile at 1 o'clock is by a couple of ravens. I see eight eagles right now. Nine. Not bad. I'm not gonna go down any further though. I'd rather keep going upstream looking for other things. Yeah, there's another one perched in the tree. I see dust storm out on the Sirkou Delta. I keep saying I'm going to turn around, but I'm just checking this out. I guess we'll go down a little bit further. I mean, it's a good time of night. There's not a lot of the Sirkou water coming out over here, but the channels that are coming out are small. There's still going to be some sockeye going up there. For those that you don't know, the sockeye run that comes up the Chilcat, about 90% of them will come up that desert right across from us. There's river channels out there. They're going up, they're turning left, they're going up the circuit about 4 miles. And behind those hills and in between the hills and the mountains, that's the Chilcat Lake. About a 12-mile lake. Fish and Game says 140,000 is the sweet number of sockeye to get in there. Any more than 140,000 and you start having poor returns or smaller returns, that lake can support 140,000 spawners. All right. Klukwan behind us. Here's something I learned this year. I was driving the shuttle bus for the senior center this year. And I came up to Klukwan on Mondays. I picked up this lady named Josie. And this little spot out here on the left, you see the dip in the mountains? That dip in the mountains, on December 21st, the sun pops out there, shines on Klukwan for an hour and a half. It's the only spot up here where they're getting direct sunlight. Such a good eagle day right down here. These guys are pretty active right now. So another really cool thing about this place is you can start walking if I drop you off here and you get up to the tops of those mountains and you'd be looking at one of the largest ice fields in the world. It's larger than the Juno ice field. I don't think you'd find an ice field bigger than that outside of the North and South Pole. So this this little place on the right, I'm gonna start showing you these salmon rest stops. So you see that black water? It's coming out clear. It's clear up there. Salmon are gonna swim up there, and that's gonna be a rest area. They're gonna collect their wits, kind of breathe a little bit. And if you have a good eye, you can see the color difference between the water on the left and the right.
Klahini River.
The water on the left, the Klahini, it's eroding a mountain. It's got a lot more lighter color rocks, like limestone and lots of marble. And then the Chilkat on the right, I've heard it called muddy for years. It's not really muddy. It's just got a darker rock that's coming down. More granite on the right side. I guess I can talk about stuff here that I usually don't talk about. So those mountains on the right side, those are about 40 to 50 million years old. This is the North American plate here on the right. Those mountains back there on the jagged one, that was the Pacific plate coming over here like a giant conveyor belt, scraping up different island chains, volcanoes, and then it smacked into the North American plate, and all of those mountains popped up. So all those mountains popped up 50 million years ago. There used to be volcanoes. I mean, you can follow this fault line all the way up to Denali, all the way down to the one that Fuca played off of Washington. And, yeah, it's just amazing. We still get 20 earthquakes a day in Alaska. This is the second rock slide area that you went by right after Klukwan. If you notice, there was water that was coming down on the right side. It was going under the road. This is not a good salmon spawning stream. We did see a pink salmon here earlier today. I'm fairly certain that every time a pink salmon goes in there, the eagles pick it off. But this flow will increase in February. And all
sockeye back there. Sockeyes like lakes, but these guys look comfortable here, don't they? So I did see a pink, I did see a sockeye. Anybody see a chum? Yeah.
Who's that?
There's a big sockeye further in. Big bright white, red one.
Yeah. There. So here's one thing that I really have to explain to
them. I'm gonna keep getting closer.
Always pretty far. Yeah.
So can everybody see it in the front?
Yeah.
And everybody in the back?
Yep.
You have your moose call to get it closer?
No.
Hey, Rocky.
I left the carrots at home. Mountain right now, right behind us.
Light on his camera.
Oh yeah, there's a good window here. They're not terribly worried about us. 40 pounds, so that weighs gorgeous. More than some of you toddlers. This eagle's nest up on the left. It's at 11 o'clock now. It's in the top of that tree. It's like a fish. The nest is big for Alaska, right? Oh, there's the fledgling. I see it. I see the silhouette. The sun's behind it, so all you can see is a silhouette of that little guy. Yeah, I'm glad he's back. I don't know if he went flying or not, but he may have.
Nope, snap, thank you.
So, what made with building supplies, so they could bring in a 4-foot stick and it's not gonna get caught on another tree. So it's safe to bring stuff in and out. It's wide. You can tell we haven't had a big snow year in a while. because that is a big nest and it's in a cottonwood tree, not known as the hardest tree that we have up here. And if you look, it's on two trunk branches maybe. It looks like part of it is in that little Y. But if we had 200, like what, 2011, 2012? I think it's kind of died.
Hey,
if you
bud.
Can see an eye in its right eye socket, let me know.
Pretty bird.
Yes.
I don't do this on normal trips, trust me. Doubler on it, and I got a picture of it with its missing eye. Oh, that's good. I wish I could frame that for you.
It's all good.
It's really shallow. This is called Stump Lake. I'm going to keep going forward until I start spitting out silt.
Hi. Hello.
He is chilling. Just chilling.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, really?